I'm First Alert meteorologist Jason Dunning here in Fort Myers at the IMAG History and Science Center, and we're doing very interactive experiments through Hurricane Week to explain the science of hurricanes. This experiment is a little bit different. I'm joined with Amy Lovelace. She is the Director of Education here at IMAG. Amy, welcome. We've had some pretty exciting experiments so
Absolutely.
Far this week, and it looks like we've got a coastline in a container.
We do. So we have our ocean here, we have our beach here, we have all of our animals living here. But the only difference between this coastline is that this area is just bare sand, and this area is a mangrove forest. Now, obviously, we don't have real mangroves in this little tank.
That's pretty close.
But we do have some pipe cleaners that we've put together to make it to mangroves. So if you want to do this at home, simple little way to make a little mangrove forest is just twisting some pipe cleaners together and putting them directly in the sand.
Now, obviously, we have a lot of these in Southwest Florida, mangroves, which we rely on, especially as it comes to storm surge, to help protect us. So what do you want me to do here?
So we have a glass, and that's going to be our wave generator.
Okay.
So what you're going to do is you're just going to put it in the water and push back and forth a few times to create waves.
All right.
And we'll see as those waves start eroding our shore.
Okay, it's pretty good. Oh, we lost some mangroves.
And
that's
if we're taking a look at our shoreline, our animals on this side are already washing into the water. But our animals that have the mangroves on their side are pretty well protected. They're just getting their toes wet. But our animals on this side are dealing with a little bit more storm surge, a little more devastation on this side.
Looks like we lost a...
We lost a lion from our zoo.
Lost a lion here. I mean, this is such a great illustration and why it's so important to have these more natural barriers, these living shorelines like mangroves. And you can see the difference and how much farther inland along the coast that the storm surge is able to make it. You can see there's the watermark here without any kind of natural protection, and you can see how far it goes where you have those mangroves. So definitely would want to be on this side with these animals if there was a storm, and definitely would not want to be on this side with a lion. All right, Amy, thank you so much for this great demonstration as we look at the science of hurricanes, very interactive, and been doing things throughout the week that kids can do at home with their parents. I'm First Alert meteorologist Jason Dunning here at the IMAG History and Science Center.